This resulted in a revenue deficit of 16,200 crores in the first 10 months of the new state's existence. Thus far, the government of India has released only 2,303 crores to bridge the resource gap, leaving the state with a huge revenue deficit overhang of 13,897 crores. The state received only 50 crores per district per year over the past 2 years for the development of 4 Rayalaseema and 3 North Coastal districts. Thus far, we received 850 crores for the construction of Amaravati city, Rs. 345 crores for Polavaram project, and 1,000 crores for the water supply and drainage projects for Vijayawada and Guntur cities. For industrial development of the state, the grants for construction of the capital city, reimbursement of expenditure incurred on Polavaram project since grants for construction of the capital city, and conferring special category status, all of which are integral components of the AP Reorganization Act 2014, and the assurances in Parliament have remained unfulfilled. This reality has created tremendous strain on the state's financial fiscal situation. Nevertheless, considering the credible GSDP growth in 2015-16, I expect proportionate growth of the resources enveloped in 2016-17. Overall, I expect the state's own resources to grow by 16% from 49,764 crores in 2015-16 to 57,813 crores in 2016-17. However, as mentioned earlier, the legacy of huge revenue deficit and a overhang from 2014-15 will continue to haunt us in 2016-17. We expect the central government to step up its support to the state development plan in the form of increased central assistance and special grants, apart from 3,000 crores to partially offset the revenue deficit of 2014-15 financial year. I sincerely hope that the central government would release 935 crores as compensation for the central sales tax CST that is due to us, provide 3,500 for construction of Polavaram project, 350 crores for the development of 7 relatively underdeveloped districts, and extend support for Amaravati construction with a grant of 1,000 crores. Furthermore, we earnestly hope that the goods and services tax legislation will be passed by the Parliament and will become operational in 2016-17, which will provide a boost to our tax pool.